to me and listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple.
All right, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom. Greetings to each and every last one of you in sweet, precious, and strong, and victorious, and mighty, overcoming name of our soon-coming King, Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. I hope that y'all are doing good, doing well, every single one of you. All right, let me see about rebooting this chat right here for a second. And that your week has went fine. I really, truly do hope that your week has went fine. And while we're here today, we're going to talk about a few things here. And so you might as well get your Bible out. We're going to open up our Bible here, and we're going to visit a few things here to try to bring Israel online, to try to bring us online concerning sound doctrine, the way that we are and should be as a people. I remember this past scripture study that I mentioned that freedom of speech may exist in America here, but it doesn't exist in Torah. As a matter of fact, the Bible over and over and over again teaches us how that we ought to guard our heart and our lips. As a matter of fact, I think that everybody in Israel, every single one of us, that we should spend time in study on the tongue. What does the Bible have to say about the tongue? We need to spend time on slander, gossip, tale-bearing, and backbiting. And that's it's an epidemic in Israel. It is a literal epidemic all over across the board. And I think the reason why it's an epidemic is because we really, truly just assume that everybody is going to do right, but we don't really know that they are going to do right. You know, let me give an example. If we're going to move forward as a people, I don't care how much fear, how much jealousy, how much envy, how much strife and hatred you have in you. What does it benefit for you to disclose somebody else's past? I don't care in what capacity it is, with exception of to slander their name, to have people to look at them through a false eye or a false illusion or false vision as if nobody can change. Because you know just as well as I do, as powerful as an accusation is, and an accusation is very powerful, you know just as well as I do that a lot of people through fear will paint a picture and put accusations out there, whether they be true or false, simply because they want people to view people from, rather than the perspective that someone has changed, they want them to view them from the viewpoint of their past. Now, suppose if everybody got out here and just start revealing everybody's past, well, it would be a bloodletting in Israel, wouldn't it? Are we to say that the Most High is not powerful enough to change anybody or anyone? I think that what's happening nowadays, and people have their different motives for a lot of things. But I tell you what, I think that all of us need to spend an extraordinary amount of time studying on the tongue, the slander, gossip, backbiting, tale-bearing, falsifying, lying, the whole nine yards. Everything that seems to be with the tongue, everything that seems to be with the capacity of the tongue. Everything that seems to be the reason why that we can't get along or why we have fears. Because I tell you one thing, and I want everybody to listen to me. If you're in the chat room and you can hear me, type in the letter L for listen. Type in the letter L for listen. Hallelujah. I think that one of the biggest problems we have in Israel is, and I want y'all to listen to me real closely. Not one human being on the face of planet Earth has love to the capacity of the Most High. Neither does one human being on the face of this planet Earth has mercy and grace to the capacity as the Most High. Are you folks listening to me? We all strive to be like the Most High, but the flat out truth is, according to Torah and the Tanakh, we all have limitations. We're human beings. We don't have His grace and mercy dwelling in us. We can only take so much of anything for so long. And that's just all there is to it. We have limitations. We're just going to be real here tonight, all right? And I know people that will do injustices secretly and will slander and defame and paint a false picture of people behind their back and do it for years. But I would tell you this. Human beings do not have the same mercy, grace, and forgiveness as the Most High does. Now, we strive to, but we have limitations. And I sit and watch people all over again, all the time. They can raise hell for years. They can secretly slander their neighbor for years. And they never ever think that people will get tired of that mess. And then when they repent, they want you to wipe away all the years of damage that they've done. They want you to give them a clean slate and act like ain't nothing ever done, while at the whole time your heart is dealing with betrayal. Your heart is dealing with an offense. Your heart is dealing with bitterness and resentment and ill will. And this may take you time. It may take you a long time to get past what somebody has done. It may take a long, long time. And you may never get over it. You can forgive, but you don't have to be a doormat for everybody else's iniquity. You understand that? You don't have to have them in your life to continually making you miserable. Because the truth is, there's just some things that while they can be forgiven, there's just some things that is just best to remove the people out of your life that is causing all this pain. It really truly is. And for someone to put all this evil on somebody else and then expect for all of us to act like the Most High when they've been acting like devils all this time, that's nonsensical. It really truly is. And I thank y'all for the Torah. And tonight we're going to go to the book of Acts of the Apostles, Acts chapter 13 here for a moment this evening. And we're going to do a little bit of showing you how, because most of us, we get all in a hissy fit when we don't understand correction, rebuke, instruction, the way that the Bible says. I ain't talking about the way that you learned it in Christianity or Islam or whatever religion you come from. But we're going to get in here in the book in Acts, the 13th chapter, Acts of the Apostles. And we're going to start at the 4th verse. And we're going to deal with a certain spirit. All right? A certain spirit. All right? Let me see what we got here. And it says, "And so they, being sent forth by the Holy Ghost, departed unto Seleucia, and from thence they sailed to Cyprus. And when they were at Salamis, they preached the word of Yah in the synagogues of the Yehudims." Listen to this. "And they had also John to their minister. And when they had gone through the isles unto Patmos, they found a certain sorcerer." Now, we're going to define what this Bible right here at this particular junction calls a sorcerer. We all have, because of this American influence in our society, in our minds, what a sorcerer is. Let's see what the Bible is telling us this particular kind of sorcerer is. See, we need understanding. We need understanding. All right? And look what it says right here. "They found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet, a Yehudim." He was a Jew, a Yehudim. That means he was in Israel. "Whose name was Bar-Jesus." Now listen. "Which was with the deputy of the country, Sergius Paulus, a prudent man. who called for Barnabas and Saul and desired to hear the word of Yah. Now watch this. Listen. See, what we need to do is we need to pay attention to what the Bible is defining to us what a sorcerer is today, because society has tried to define for us what a sorcerer is. You know, a witch, warlock, or someone that does incantations, spells, you know, people who communicate with the dead. You know, they got all different types of definitions for what it says sorcerer. But in order for us to understand, because remember, we also have a watered-down version of the Hebrew Scriptures in front of us, and so we have a gauntlet to run through just in order to get understanding. And so we need to stick with what the Bible is saying so we can understand what a sorcery is when it is operating amongst us as Israel, according to what the book says. And so we're going to stick with the Bible, which I believe is the best. It defines itself. It always does. So let us look what it says right. Look what it says. But Elimelech, you hear that? Elimelech, the sorcerer, for so is his name by interpretation. So here's a man that is a Yehudim, what the Bible says a Jew. That means he's an Israelite. And his name means sorcerer. You hear that? All right? Look what it says right here. Withstood them. That is what a sorcerer is today, Israel. Are y'all hearing me? A sorcerer today, under our Hebrew definition, is anyone that opposes someone who is preaching and ministering the gospel of Yahshua HaMashiach. Do y'all hear me? Are y'all hearing me, Israel? A sorcerer, in our Hebraic understanding, in context of what this book is saying right here, is someone who opposes and someone who goes against anyone who is preaching and teaching and ministering, are you following me? The word of Yahshua HaMashiach, the gospel. Now think about this. He's given us gifts: apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. Now if you ain't none of them, the last thing you want to do is oppose someone who is truly ministering the gospel. So it says in verse 8 of Acts 13, but Elimelech the sorcerer, so his name by interpretation, withstood them. What was the purpose he withstood them? Look what his character was. Seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. Y'all hear that? Not only do they oppose people, but have you ever thought, what could someone say to you that would cause you to not hear the word of God any longer? And it would cause you to turn from the faith. Because the only way that could happen is somebody has to say something to you. Somebody has to oppose the people who are bringing the message and get you off of the ones who are bringing the message to detour you and get you out of the kingdom. Now, what might that be? What is your temptation? What could somebody say to you to deter you, to get you off course and out of the faith? No matter who, no matter what they said, if it can knock you off kilter and it can get you out of the faith and you no longer are walking with the people who are ministering the word of Yah, you have just got finished being influenced by a sorcerer. Do you understand? Do you understand, Israel? And I'll say it again. Do you understand? Notice we're still here in verse 8, and we've been here quite a while. We ain't left yet. Let's get back to it again. Verse 8. But Elimelech the sorcerer, for so is his name by interpretation. Look what he did, his action, his character. Withstood them. What was the sole purpose withstood? Look, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. How many times we see people arguing and debating and fighting over someone who's telling the truth, but because they have church doctrine, because they wasn't reared and raised that way, or because they hate the preacher. How many times we've seen people with this kind of character and nature spew out their poison and inject it into your hearts and minds for the sole purpose to get you to no longer listen to those who you should be listening to,
Because what they're putting down and what they're saying, they don't have enough gospel anointing or word in them that or character or nature that anyone will want to follow. I'm trying to tell you. Now, let's get back to it over here. Verse 9. Then Saul, who also is called Paul. Let's see what his character and nature is. Because, you know, here in society, we're not familiar with someone who rebukes someone openly. We're not familiar with someone who's going to bring the hammer and be a watchman and warn. As a matter of fact, as soon as somebody rebukes, somebody reproves, somebody corrects, somebody exhorts or admonishes, it rubs us the wrong way because we've been raised in mind Gentile Americans and we don't know how to function the way that we should. And we have lost our ever-loving way. What do you think about that? We're going to stick with the Bible now. I'm not going to Webster's. I'm not going to Wikipedia. I'm not going to the history books. I'm not going to archaeology. I'm going with the reference we have in front of us right now. Let's go on. Verse 9, Acts 13 again. Then Saul, who just happened to be an apostle. That means whether you believe him to be an apostle or not is totally irrelevant. He's written about in his book. That's just like me. Whether you believe I'm a pastor or not is totally irrelevant because all the people that listen to me are a seal of my pastorship. How many people you got listening to you out there that seals your ministry? Better think about that. Listen here for a second. Then Saul, who also is called Paul, filled with the Holy Ghost, set his eyes on him, and look at how he approached him. Let's see what Paul said to Elymelius, the sorcerer, who was seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. Let's see what he said. And said, oh, full of subtlety and all of mischief. And all mischief. Look what he says. Thou child of the devil. Now, wait a minute. We would call that out of character. We would say today in this society that Paul has no right calling this man a devil. I think that the Apostle Paul knew a devil when he saw a devil. Mind you, what we're forgetting is this. This Elymelius the sorcerer was a Yehudim. He was a Jew. He was an Israelite in the faith seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. I know it's appalling. I know it is because we don't ever read it like that. I know it is utterly amazing. Huh? That's because for many of you, the first time in your life, you're hearing a preacher. Let's go on again. So Paul called him, he's full of subtlety. That means he's full of deceit. Huh? And full of mischief, cunning, lying, deceptive ways. Huh? Then he said, you are a child of the devil. Then look what he, not only that, but he called him, look at this. Mind you, Elymelius was a Yehudim. He was an Israelite. Are y'all listening? And from one of the tribes of Judah. And he says, you enemy of all righteousness. See, I think the problem is today that we get shocked and appalled because we think that everybody say that they're Israel, they're Israel. And as soon as we see somebody acting out of character and acting just like this sorcerer, Elymelius right here, it never registers into our heart and mind because we have not hidden the scriptures in our heart. We don't know the book. So when somebody is acting like this, we have no spirit of recall because we have not studied to show ourselves approved. So if somebody in Israel raised up and act like a sorcerer, seeking to turn away people from the faith, we wouldn't be able to discern it. We are inept. It's just sad, the conditioning of our mindset today. We hate, and not only that, oh, Pastor Dow, why did Paul resort to name calling? He called him a child of the devil. That's child of Satan. Said he was full of mischief, deceit, full of subtlety, lying, cunning, deceitful, naming them out, calling them out in front of everybody. Now, look what he says right here. You enemy of righteousness, will you not cease to pervert the right ways of Yahshua the Master? I'm sorry, folks. If they had it back then, we got the same type of people in the midst of us today. And only those who are called by the Most High Yah is going to have enough boldness to call these devils out for the sake of Israel. And now behold, the hand of Yahshua is on thee, is upon thee. Notice, let's see what Paul did. And thou shalt be blind. What? Oh, wait a minute. You mean to tell me that Paul cursed this man with blindness? If you're going to speak blindness on somebody, boy, you got some power. You speaking something. Now, what would we say about that today? And mind you, we're in the New Testament too, ain't we? We're in the New Testament. The Renewed Covenant. The Berit Chadashah. Now, look what he says. And now, the hand of Yahshua is upon thee, and thou shalt be blind, not seeing the sun for a season. And immediately there fell upon him the mist, a mist of darkness. And he went about seeking some to lead him by the hand. Watch this. When rebuke and reproof and correction, and then the power of Yah follows that rebuke and reproof and correction. Look what happened to the one who Ananias the sorcerer. Look what he was doing. Look what happened to the one that he was trying to deceive to turn him away from the faith. Let's see what happens. Then the deputy, when he saw what was done. How many times y'all come here and seen the power of Yah operating in the midst of this assembly right here? How many times y'all seen the power of Yah demonstrated from this pastor right here, who has the evidence of the Ruah operating in his life? How many times? How many times? From one end of this earth to the next. People getting saved, healed, and delivered, set free. How many times? See, many of you haven't been around enough to know when I've spoken judgment on people. Because with the way your plastic mind is today, you would think that's out of order because of your rearing in Christianity. But see, I'm a student of the book. I don't mind speaking judgment on anybody anytime. You know why? Because we all are going to see, one way or the other, who the Most High Yah has chosen and who he has his hand on. And whether you like it or not, it is a serious woe unto you when you step out of your limitations and out of your bounds and you assume to attack me, who you didn't call, but the Most High did. You understand what I'm saying? I'm a pastor called by the Most High Yah, and this is an apostle. And boy, for people to sit up there and to have the audacity and the arrogancy to think that they can touch Yah's anointing is beyond me. There's no fear in this generation. Not until judgment is pronounced. And you better believe, I'll tell you what, I'm getting real quick about definitely putting forth judgments. Listen to the book. And then the deputy saw that was done, believe. Being astonished at the look, doctrine of Yahshua. Well, how was he astonished at that doctrine? Because he heard the Apostle Saul doctrine. And he believed. And that caused him to believe in Jesus. How many of you listening to me that caused you to believe in the real Jesus and not the false Jesus that Christianity preaches? So you see, the Bible in the Renewed Covenant just got finished defining for us a sorcerer is someone who seeks to turn you away from a Yah called man. The Elymaeus didn't believe that the apostle was called. Other than that, they would have never opposed him, would they? But then Yah backs up his man every single time. Hallelujah. I think we just got finished learning a lot. Many of you probably read that story 1,000 times and never got that out of it. Isn't that right? Anyway, we've done enough preaching here just this Shabbat. On this Shabbat right here, I hope that you're edified and that some way, somehow, you gain some understanding, because that's what I'm supposed to do. I'm a pastor. I'm supposed to feed you with knowledge and understanding. That's my job. Jeremiah 3:15, and I will give you, pastors. Notice who's doing the giving. The Most High Yah is. According to my heart. It makes no difference if you don't receive I'm a pastor or not. Totally irrelevant. You didn't make me. You didn't call me. The Most High did. But he said he's going to give Israel pastors according to his heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. You just got finished having a smorgasbord put before your face and before your eyes. You just got finished having understanding that you would never get from any other of these religions in this so-called free world. You know why? Because it has to be preached by a Hebrew in order for you to get understanding. The Most High Yah is the one that has to call him to minister to his people. Hallelujah. All right. So with that said, we're going to go ahead and go to the phone line. The guest call-in number is 310-982-4226. The guest call-in number is 310-982-4226. Hallelujah. I'll be back here in just a moment. We'll take a break. Hallelujah. Listen to a little bit of Joanne Hosanna, and then after that, we'll come back to your phone calls. The guest call-in number is 310-982-4226. I tell you what, Stella Joanna, we'll give you a radio ministry break, all right? 310-982-4226. If you want to get in the guest caller queue, once you hear the queue, you press 1, it'll put you in the switchboard. Myself and El Brother Shane will know that you are there. Hallelujah.
We're glad to have each and every last one of you here tonight listening to us on Blog Talk Radio.
That was beautiful, huh?
Yeah, now, I love it.
If you'd like to contact us, our phone number is area code 615-688-3025. That is again, 615-688-3025. If you'd like to correspond with us, or you'd like to support this particular ministry with your gifts, your offerings, or letter of support, you can send it to Pastor Charles Dowell. That is Pastor Charles Dowell. And the last name is spelled D-O-W-E-L-L. That is Pastor Charles Dowell. You can send your letter to 632 Highway 52 Bypass West. That's 632 Highway 52 Bypass West. PMB number 1 Lafayette, Tennessee. Lafayette is spelled L-A-F-A-Y-E-T-T-E, Tennessee. And the area code is 37083. Again, the mailing address is Pastor Charles Powell, Highway 632, 52 Bypass West, PMB number 1, Lafayette, Tennessee, 37083. Our website is www.straightwaytruth.com, and that is spelled StraightwayTruth.com. That is the StraightwayTruth.com or StraightwayTruth.com. You can also find us on YouTube. If you would go to YouTube and type in my name, Pastor Dowell, P-A-S-T-O-R-D-O-W-E-L-L. There, you can find many teaching videos. We preach and teach on just about everything that the scriptures has to offer. We also have a Bible deliverance ministry. We teach people about health. And we also speak to you about how important it is to obey the covenant of the Most High. We hope to hear from you, you and you. That is our prayer. The King is coming.
All right. We are back. Hey, we are blessed because Elder Bill has been up here with us the whole entire week. He's been staying in my home this whole week. We thank the Father for it. And Sister Carol has been helping Elder Bill out, giving him the nice herbs and everything he needs. And also, we've got Elder Donnie and Sister Ajalee and little Halo up visiting from New Orleans, Louisiana. Elder Donnie and his lovely wife and family is up here visiting us as well. And we thank the Father for them. We really, really, truly do. Glory to the King. We're going to the phone calls. Going to the phone line now. I hope that y'all got edified by the teaching. And I hope that you would let these sayings sink deep down in your heart. Now, let me say this. Do you see the reason why you need a pastor? Do you see the reason why you need a pastor? Do you see it? All right. Let's go to Junior. Caller number 631-631 from New York. Brother Junior, it's Pastor Dow. You on the Straight Way Truth radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Junior?
Shabbat Shalom, Pastor and Saint. Elder Donnie, Elder Bill. Doing good, right? You doing good?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Doing good.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus, for that. Yes. Shalom, Pastor. Thank you for the shirt, too. Thank you so much. I love that shirt.
Oh, man. Is that all right, Junior?
Yes, sir. I love it. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thank you so much, man. Appreciate it. Sir.
Man, boy, I tell you what, you can rock that up in New York, can't you?
Oh, yes, sir. I can rock that, yes. I mean, Hebrew Israelite. That's my heritage.
Hallelujah.
Lord, that I'm going to. That's beautiful.
What you got, Junior?
Beautiful. Oh, yes, sir, yeah. That teaching on Thursday, beautiful. It's very beautiful, man. You got to watch what you say, generally. Got to hold that tongue.
Well, think about it. What destroyed our people in the wilderness? Murmuring, wasn't it?
Murmuring, yes. That's right.
That tongue, man, it's an epidemic in Israel.
Yes, sir.
It really is, brother.
Yes, sir. Book of Numbers tells that, too. I'll be reading that. Go over there, stick in the toilet.
Bar Mikbar.
Yes, sir. Bar Mikbar. Right.
Yes, sir.
Reading that, sticking the Torah, reading the New Testament, same thing. It's not a Old Testament, it's a summary testament, not New Testament, it's a summary testament. I'm correct, right?
Yeah, you all right there, Junior. You know what I mean? But, you know, it's the gospel, it's the letters, man, brother, but it's not scripture.
Exactly.
That doesn't mean that we're trying to diminish it in what it's saying, but it's there to support scripture. And if anybody brings a perspective to us using the New Testament or the Renewed Covenant and trying to change what the scripture is saying, we know that's a lying spirit.
Yeah. Right. Antichrist. Yes, sir. It's a summary. This is my opinion here. Summary Testament is a summary of the scriptures, right?
Yeah, that's basically what they're doing, Junior. They're elaborating on them, but they have to understand these are chosen men of Yado that has broke this thing down. So, you can't diminish their calling or their office. Makes no difference. You know, today in society, do we not have people who reject Paul as an apostle?
Oh, yes, sir.
Yep. Hey, it's just totally irrelevant if they reject him as apostle. He's still an apostle. Their rejection does not change him being an apostle one bit. People reject me as a pastor. I don't care. It doesn't stop me from being a pastor one bit. You understand what I mean? I cannot stop being a pastor simply because somebody don't like me no more or love me. You understand what I mean?
That's crazy. God chose you. He don't change nothing. It's
well,
God's job.
I think the problem is that people put too much stock and they have a very high and lofty opinion of their own self or their own self-worth.
Okay, sir.
But we're going to find out who y'all's anointed is one way or the other. We are.
Yes, right, yeah.
And I'm willing to test that boast.
Oh, yeah. I believe it. You might pass forever.
As a matter of fact, we ain't got no choice but to test that boast anyway.
the only way is to greatness, to live for him. That's it. You know, people are talking about, y'all, what do you say, Pastor?
No, go ahead, Junior.
Okay. Yeah, people are watching my mouth, everything say you're cursing yourself, too. If you curse someone, you curse yourself, too, if I'm correct, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything you do, like, I do some simple stuff to you. Anyone in general, I curse myself, too. I curse someone, what be done to you. Any harder, I watch you do, too. Why don't you say what you do, too, in general? Wow. That's a good service. I love that. Like, people talk about you, man. Our people talk, our own people, man. They will awaken. They don't change. They don't stop.
Well, I mean, we just got finished seeing Animanius was a sorcerer. He was a Yehudim. He was a Yehudim, Junior.
Mm-hmm.
In Israel. So this ain't, they ain't nothing new under the sun.
Yeah. Exactly. It's new or up. Ain't nothing. It's been going for, since the beginning of time. You know, snakes anyway.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, like I did that video today about the preparing for America, like country gardening.
Yeah.
Thank you for correcting that video too. You correct me on that video too. I got corrected some errors too. I corrected. I love that. That's how you preach. I love that.
All right, Junior. I appreciate it.
All right, Pastor. That's it. I'll see you tomorrow. Love you, Pastor. Shabbat Shalom. Take care.
Shabbat Shalom, my brother. Good hearing from you. Always, Junior. Shabbat Shalom. All right, let's go to Texas to Sister Nastasha, caller number 469-469. It's Pastor Dow. You're on Straight With Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you? Are you there? Sister Nastasha.
Shalom, Pastor. Bless you. Shabbat Shalom. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Doing well. How can I help you?
Hello? Can you hear me, Pastor?
Yes, I can hear you.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, I'm sorry about that. I'm not sure what happened. I just want to say Shabbat Shalom to you and all the saints scattered abroad. I wanted to share a quick testimony, if that's okay with you. It'll be really quick.
Sure, go ahead.
I just wanted to give a praise report, which I should have done last week, but after speaking with Sister Angela about her healing, I thought that I would share last Friday, I was in a car wreck. F-150 hit me. I had a light concussion. I had never experienced anything like that before. I knew it was the devil when it happened. I rebuked it. I was healed in less than 24 hours. Sister Rachel laid hands on me. The brothers prayed for me. I called the brothers, and they did a prayer together. And I was healed by the morning of Shabbat so that I could praise as hard as I normally do. You see me praise, and that's... I knew Satan didn't want me to do that, and I knew that I had to focus on my spiritual side more than anything than my physical side or the financial side. So I just wanted to share that. I hope that somebody's touched by that. I know that Yahweh is alive. I believe in his healing, and I believe that he uses his brother, his daughters and sons as vessels to heal as well, and I just wanted to share that, and I'm just so thankful, so gracious that he chose little old me to be a daughter of Zion, a little old me, to save me, to heal me. I'm just so grateful, and I believe in his power. I just hope somebody is blessed by that.
Well, hallelujah. It's good to hear from you, sister, and we thank y'all for that wonderful testimony of his power and might, and we're glad that you're okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you. I love you so much. Thank you for your obedience once again. And Shabbat Shalom to everyone scattered abroad.
Hallelujah. Shabbat Shalom. Boy, I tell you, the power of the Most High God, we thank the Father that he preserved our sister, and she got healed. She got healed, no doubt. You know, no doubt the devil working. He's just definitely working. Let's go over here back again to New York to Brother Ani. Caller number 347-347. This is Pastor Dow. You're on Straight With Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you, brother?
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom,
Israel.
Shabbat Shalom.
So glad that Elder Bill feeling good.
Yeah, Elder Bill feeling real good. He said, at least that's what he told me.
Hallelujah. God, you keep preaching, brother. Don't stop.
Keep. Yeah, all I need is just the people who receive me as a pastor. All I need is your prayers to combat against all the enemies and the idiots out there that try to fight against Israel.
Yeah,
Because they ain't going to fight against me anyway, because, you know, the scriptures clearly say, touch not his anointed and do his prophets no harm. So no doubt I'm anointed. So, you know, they do it on their own apparel.
Shabbat shalom, shepherd. Have a good rest.
Hallelujah. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. That was Brother Ami, New York there. Let's go to New Jersey. Calling number 856. We're going to go to Brother Ron in New Jersey. Brother Ron, this is Pastor Dow. We're on the Straight With You radio broadcast. How can I help you, my brother?
Shabbat shalom, my pastor. Shabbat shalom, my Israelite brothers and sisters scattered abroad and on so far mountain.
Hallelujah. Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah. That right there, that's just something else. That is something else, Pastor. Back to spiritual warfare again. I had a question about scripture that actually ties into the tongue. If you could explain this for me here, it's Ecclesiastes in the Apocrypha chapter 5, verse 14. Be not called a whisperer, and lie not in wait with thy tongue. So, someone who lies in wait with their tongue would be someone, well, listen to the verse. For a foul shame is upon the thief, and evil condemnation upon the double tongue. So could you break that down, Pastor?
Yeah. It says, be not called a whisperer. In other words, you know what I mean, someone who actually secretly goes around as slander. Because remember, in the we just went over the scripture study that a whisperer has a character, a nature of someone that is a slanderer. Remember?
Yeah.
It's not talking about people going around whispering in somebody's ear or telling them something. It's talking about one that's slandering, all right? Look what it says right here.
Yeah.
And lie not in wait with thy tongue. The tongue is what brings forth life and death. And when it's using the words of saying lie not in wait, they're just like saying people lie not in wait to do mischief, lie not in wait to kill, lie not in wait to murder, lie not, you know, people just setting people up to do bad to them. You understand what I mean? So don't use your tongue to set up doing bad and slandering and defaming and speaking evil about others. Because remember, life and death is in the power of the tongue. For a foul shame is upon the thief, and an evil condemnation upon the double tongue. People don't understand that life and death work both ways. When you speak death with your tongue, it's going to come back on you. It's going to come back on you. It's going to visit you. We're charged to exhort. We're charged to edify. We're charged to do whatever we can, especially amongst our own people. Then it says, and be not ignorant of anything in a great matter or small. But that's one thing about us. We are definitely an ignorant people because we choose to be dumb on purpose. Especially when we got all this preaching and teaching, this information highway out there. There's no reason whatsoever at all for any of us to be ignorant.
Okay,
yeah,
okay. See, that lie not in wait with thy tongue got me. That brings up. Thank you, Pastor. Hallelujah.
Man, people be murdering and killing people with their tongue, brother. They're after your soul. That's what the book says. David said, man, they're after his soul. Anybody who speaks evil of you, brother, they're after your soul.
So Absalom, speaking of David, would be a good example of someone who was lying in wait for his tongue.
Yep. Look what he did. Did he not go around and try to draw people to himself away from the real true king of Israel?
Mm-hmm.
Did he not speak evil of his father?
Yes, he did.
All right, then, there you have it.
All right. Ooh. All right, bless you, Pastor. Bless you, bless you, bless you. Bless all my brothers and my sisters out there scattered abroad. Continue to feed us and to cut us with that sword, Pastor, because we need it.
Well, hallelujah. Bless you, Brother Ron. Shabbat shalom. Let's go to Elder Bullock, 512 there in North Carolina. Elder Bullock, 512. This is Pastor Dow. Elder, how you doing?
Yeah, doing fine, Pastor. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, Shabbat shalom. How can I help you, Elder?
Oh, I hope you're taking care of yourself up there in this nice cold weather.
Well, yeah, I've actually been doing a pretty good job of doing that. I've actually been exercising, and I've been running that hill.
Running the hill?
Yes, sir. I've been running the hill.
Well, I
mean, after all, you're a little bit older than I am, so I understand, but there's a lot of young people that can't deal with that hill, Elder.
Hello, Pastor, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, you cut out on me then.
I said there's a lot of younger people that can't even deal with that hill, but you got to cut your computer down when you're talking with me, Elder.
Computer's not on.
Well, we got a feedback or something going on.
Let's see. Okay, maybe that's...
Is it the speakerphone?
Hey, how about now? You still getting it?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Oh, okay. I had my phone plugged into an external speaker. I think that was made of doing it.
Yep, that's what it do it.
Okay.
Yeah, but there's a lot of...
Well, anyway, I just wanted to speak there. Yeah, I had spoken to you since I left there, and man, we sure enjoyed being there. We had a great time. We were really blessed.
Well, we enjoyed y'all, you and Mother, but we definitely enjoyed y'all, Elder.
Yeah, man, I tell you, but at the deliverance service, that was awesome. And man, I don't know anybody who talks against you and saying that you're not a pastor or anything like that, man, they need to be there and see what's going on.
Well, I mean, you know, we're going to have people to do that. You know, that's just part of it. They're going to have people do that. But, hey, glory to the King. All glory to the King.
Okay, then. Well, I'll let you go. And Shabbat Shalom to you. And I'll be looking forward to in the morning hearing your sermon.
All right. Shabbat Shalom, Elder. Shabbat Shalom. Let's go to Brother Eric in Nebraska, calling number 308. 308, Brother Eric in Nebraska. This is Pastor Dow. You're on the Stream 2 radio broadcast. How can I help you, Brother Eric?
Bless you.
Bless you.
Here I am again at your doorstep, Mike Russo, my anointed pastor of the Most High, huh?
Hallelujah.
Hey.
I'm doing all right.
You and go ahead, sir.
No, I said I'm doing all right. Go ahead, Brother Eric.
I'm very happy to hear that. How's your back doing, by the way, sir?
It's doing pretty good. I've been doing a little bit of weightlifting, a little exercise there, Brother Eric, and I've been running this hill back here. I've been running that hill. Actually, over the past week, brother, I've actually shaved 1 minute of time off my time running that hill.
That's awesome. I'm glad to hear that, sir. I want to get more physical myself. That's inspiring. I need to get after it.
Hallelujah.
Great. I just had something I wanted to say to you and the saints at Straightway this evening.
Go ahead.
And what I'd like to say is I am gaining more wisdom as I keep walking in the Torah of my Father, and I'm seeing how much has truly been lost. The characteristics that the nations consider normality are offensive abominations to our Father and His people.
Yeah. Amen.
And the more I read with understanding, the more I realize how patient and how long-suffering you and the Straightway Saints truly are. And for that, I just wanted to say thank you and bless you.
Well, you're welcome, Brother Eric. You're welcome. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Glory to the King. Let's go to Brother Steve Brother Steve in Canada. Hallelujah. Brother Steve 705 is Pastor Dowdy on the Straight Truth Radio broadcast. How can I help you? You know, Brother Steve, I'm going to, I'm getting, everything is slowing down and it's getting ready to get back in time for me to start paying more attention to the broadcast and the ministry as a whole in itself. At least I'm trying to. How can I help you, Brother Steve?
Shabbat shalom, Pastor, and all the saints at Straightway, and everyone across the whole country and everywhere else. This is Shabbat shalom from myself and Sister Wenda.
Shabbat shalom, Sister Wenda. Shabbat shalom.
Well, we want to send a shout out and thank you for all the great teaching, and also coming straight out tonight with right out of the chute for the Shabbat with some teachings as well, so we thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Oh, yeah. I just want to share some, when Sister Wenda's actually doing quite well, and one of the big things is like building some bone mass, and everyone's been talking about like using glucosamine and chondroitin, but the thing is about that is that it's, they use pig's ears and shellfish.
Ah.
But we found out a great way of doing it, and what most people's diet is actually really low on is boiling bones in soup. So that's really helpful for building up your bones and your tendons.
Really? What, like chicken bones or something like that?
Yes, sir. Chicken bones, beef bones.
Oh, that sounds good.
That's easy to do.
Wow.
Most people's diets now are just so instant, they don't use the bones. And so I've been going over to some grocery stores or farmers and trying to get some bones and then getting that all set up and having some beautiful soup.
Well, how do you make the soup, Rusty?
Well, we steep the bones right in some good water, and what you're doing is you're getting everything from the marrow coming right out, and
right.
And make sure you get some good bone with some cartilage, and boil yourself up some soup, because most people don't do that anymore, and you got to start wondering why so many older people have hip problems or getting, you know, slipping like Sister Wenda did. So, you know, we need to get our diet back into a good order.
Well, you're definitely right about that. But thank you for the wisdom.
Yes, sir. And, also, we just found out something else that is really good. It's called horsetail. We just found out about this.
Yep, it's a good herb. And,
yes, sir. And so that's actually really good for, what is this, it's the exact same thing for building up the cartilage. So I just want to share that, and I want to send out a Shabbat Shalom to everyone and yourself. And I haven't called in for a while, and we just settled in officially yesterday, or actually Tuesday, in our new home.
Really?
Yes, sir. It's a rental unit until we find, we're still fetching for some land. And
is that rental home that y'all had right now, is it bigger than the last place y'all had?
Actually, they're both the same size, but it's better laid out, and we're on lakefront again.
Again?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Yeah, it sure takes care of us.
Is it a beautiful view?
Oh, it's an absolutely gorgeous view. I'm going to have to take a photo and upload it and send you a shot of it. We, the lake has a sandy silt base. It's of limestone, so when the sun peers over, it looks like turquoise.
Wow. Well, I'm glad y'all got another place like that, boy, because that last place, that had a beautiful view, boy. We enjoyed that porch, except for when the mosquitoes came out.
Yeah, they can get nasty. Well, actually, there's less mosquitoes where we are here as well. There's no black flies.
Oh, really? What, y'all? Okay, all right, I got you.
Yes. They get really nasty, and they take a chunk out of you.
They sure do.
Wait.
They sure do, boy. They got black fires up there in Canada that are like vampires, boy. When they bite you, man, they dig off in your skin and pull and leave big old, and you start bleeding all over the place. The boogers got fangs.
They do. They sure do, Pastor. Well, thanks for, really looking forward to your teaching tomorrow morning and or tomorrow afternoon. And we'll be, like you said, you're getting yourself settled off so we can get on some other works that we need to get out there.
All right.
I'm ready for you.
All right, my brother. Shalom, shalom. Shabbat shalom.
Right,
tell you what, it's a joy going up there visiting Brother Stevens and Sister Wendy. It really truly is. Let's go to theory. All right, Brother Sean 333, what you got, brother? What you got? Give us the news.
Hey, what's going on, Pastor?
All right, my man. All right. I'm doing all right. What you going to lay on us?
All right. I just got a few things tonight. The company Boeing.
Yeah.
Pete Martin. They just won the next contract from the Pentagon. For the it's the next generation long range Stryker bomber plane type thing. Yeah, and they're planning to get 100 of them to add to the fleet, and they're not wanting to spend more than $550 million on each individual bomber. They want 100 of them.
Man,
I give you an idea of what they're going to spend. Yeah. Okay, and then I've noticed a lot of movement. With the FDA, I've noticed like they have a lot more stuff going on. Like here's a report right here. The FDA approves General Electric to have a radioactive imaging chemical, and it's to help screen patients for Alzheimer's and dementia. And the drug, what it's called, the name of it, this might be the wrong way to say it, but it's Fizamil. And basically, remember last time, I think you remember me telling you about the imaging of the brain. They're trying to learn, like, you know, how emotions play with the imaging and stuff, like, so they can kind of learn, like, what effects are happening when someone sees something that triggers an emotion.
Right.
And with this right here, it's kind of like another thing of that. But it's another thing that General Electric is, you know, got patents for and stuff, and I just want to report that. And then I got another thing over here. The FDA just approved a more powerful, more pure hydrocodone, and it's basically, if I had to like explain it, I would say it's kind of like how Oxycontin is time released, but hydrocodone just made their version of the time release kind of thing. It's a little bit more potent when it's spent, so you could definitely, you know, and the FDA has been doing a lot of stuff recently. I've been kind of watching their moves. And I got another report from the FDA. The FDA panel backs the lead scientist's hepatitis C drug. And it's just another thing we're kind of up to right now. And let's see what else I got here. Okay, there's a bunch more earthquakes are kind of going on over towards the Pacific, the Northwest Pacific, over towards Japan and Philippines and everything. And I don't know if you've seen any of the new reports, but Fukushima has another small tsunami coming in. They just had like a 7.1, I believe.
Where?
And they got warnings again. What's that?
Where at?
Over there at Fukushima, they're starting to evacuate again the Fukushima nuclear plant because there's like it's not a big tsunami coming because of the earthquake, but it's another one coming. And there was a shooting. I forget where it was. I think it was like California, and it leads to like a high-speed police chase and everything. And there was a guy who shot two people, and he had two hostages in the trunk of his car. He ended up getting in a shootout with the police and ended up dying. And then I got a few more things over here. Another company that did another oil spill, Chevron. Chevron in 2011 had an oil spill in Brazil, and not too many people knew about that. You know, I just want to call and say something about that. And then as well as there was another oil spill issue going on with BP, and it's somewhere out in North Dakota. And BP Oil had another oil spill in North Dakota somewhere. And then I have one more report right here. It's a very rare whale. It's called the saber-toothed whale. It's kind of like northern Alaska in Japanese waters. And those are starting to wash up ashore now as well because of the Fukushima radioactive stuff.
Wow. What can I say?
I had a few more things going on. What is that, Pastor? I'm sorry.
I was like, wow, what can I say, man? It's just one thing after another going on in this world. I think it's a lot of this stuff that the government is doing.
Yeah. It's getting bad. It's just getting real bad. I mean, it only gets worse each day. And I hate kind of telling people the news sometimes because, like, you know, they just think, like, you're kind of, like, always being, like, what's the word?
Gloom and doom.
Like, pessimistic.
Yeah, pessimistic.
There you go, yeah. Yeah, and that's the reality of what it is when you allow wicked people to be in control. You know what I'm saying? And like the way I always tell people, it's like, you know, it didn't have to go this way. You know, more people could, you know, kind of have more sense, you know, more morals, you know, more character, and it could be a better place. But when, you know, they're so distracted with things, and you know, they're just so caught up they can't pay attention to what's going on, that leaves a huge opportunity for wicked to come in and, you know, weave some webs, you know what I'm saying, as they like to say. And it's just getting real bad, you know. But that's basically all I had for you as a report.
Well, Sean, I do appreciate it, brother, every time you come on and fill us in with the happenings in this world. But we definitely need to know so we can keep an eye out and know what's going on so we'll know what moves we need to make. Thank you, Theory.
Yeah, no problem. And I'd like to try to somehow get your number. I'll call a few times, and I usually don't get through, but I've kind of been a little bit busy the past few months, and I'm kind of getting to where I'm settling down a little bit here. It's getting cold and everything, and I figured I might try to get up with you sometime and you know, come see you finally and stuff.
All right. Well, just call the dining hall.
All right. Yeah, I'll try it again.
All right. Bless you.
All right. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. All right, let's go to Georgia. Brother Jake. Brother Jake in Georgia, 404 is Pastor Dowell on the Straightway Truth. How can I help you?
Right along, Pastor. How you doing?
We blessed on the Most High Yah. How are you?
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. What an awesome Yah we serve. I got a brief testimony. I was working a couple of days ago, and some of my equipment had a black widow spider on it. And I worked with this piece of equipment all day. And at the end of the day, I saw the spider where he had it. I saw the web, and then I saw the spider where he was at, and I killed him. And when I killed him, the place I was at, I went into the house I was at, and I started thanking Yah and just praising him and dancing and shouting, because I could have been bit. And it just led me to know that Yah has me covered. I pray to the Most High every day. I ask Him to cover me and my family, and I truly believe it deep in my heart. And it could have been a real bad situation. Just one wrong move would have been a real bad situation. And I was by myself at the time also. And so I just wanted to share that with the saints to let them know that if they're faithful, God is definitely faithful. And He's there for us. Also, we get to spiritual warfare. I've been enjoying all the messages. Everything that you do, I enjoy, or that the Most High gives you, and it's for me to hear. I enjoy. But I realize, you know, as you get older, you get a little stubborn or whatever. But I realize how wicked man's heart can be. And I say, man, I eat myself and my thoughts, and how I have to constantly fight myself, because 1 minute I find myself praising Yah, the next minute something pop in my head and take me down a whole nother different direction. So I'm constantly on the battlefield with that, and that's a real battlefield, because the old man had plenty of time to develop himself over the past 44, 45 years or whatever. So I just want to share that with the, I feel like I'm shaming the devil by speaking out against him, and praising Yah, and I just wanted to share that with all the saints and with you, and check on you, see how you're doing, and that's pretty much all I have to say about you.
All right. Bless you. Good hearing from you.
Thank you.
Shalom. Man, I see right now I'm about to give me another cell phone because I got people sending me stupid text messages as if they are a preacher and teacher and got to understand and don't understand nothing. All right, well, whatever. All right, let's go to Texas, 979. I wonder why there's somebody who don't believe me to be their pastor. Why in the world are they listening to me in the first place? That is stupid as hell. That is dumb. That is so stupid. What are you listening for? If you ain't going, what are you going to look for if you ain't going to change and be edified? Is that not, oh boy, anyway, I told you, this brother must be bipolar or schizophrenic or something. He's got some problems. Anyway, 979, just go to Texas, 979. This is Pastor Dow. How can I help you?
Hey, Pastor Dow, what's going on?
All right, how you doing?
I'm good. This is Desmond and Shayla from Houston, Texas.
Who is it?
Desmond.
All right, bless you, brother Desmond.
We from Houston, and we've been on a journey for about several months, you know, studying all this stuff and studying the truth, you know, by ourselves, you know. And we knew the next step because, you know, going out into the world and then coming back, you know, it was hard on us knowing all this truth. And so we prayed about it, and we just asked the Father, you know, send us some people and to fellowship with, and, you know, the same like-minded people. And, you know, he answered our prayers because I ended up going on your website, and I found Brother Mitchell down here in Houston. And we met up, and we had a day, and we discussed everything. The next day was the Sabbath, and so we went to Mother Brenda's house, and we had a really good time. We enjoyed the service, and we going back, you know, this morning for some more. It's just been a blessing, and we really love your teaching too.
Well, bless you. Bless you.
Oh, bless you too. But we're gonna have a letter for you in the mail.
All right. Well, I'll be looking forward to it. Shalom.
All right. Shalom.
All right. Let's go to Sister Marjorie down in Grand Pass, Oregon. 541-541. Pastor Dow, how you doing, Sister Marjorie?
Hi, Pastor Dow. Thank you for taking my call.
All right. You're welcome.
Yes, first of all, Steve's information was really interesting because my mom always cooked the balls. Chickens, well, she would make soup, she would include balls and stuff, and it always tasted tasty. And so when I make soup now, what I end up doing is using like a breast, and then I'll add like that chicken soup on the shelf, and then I don't have chickens here, but Pastor Dow, I wish I did. But anyhow, and then I add my vegetables, stuff like that, and it just didn't have that good taste. And then my girlfriend, real quick, every time her family gets sick, she always puts on a whole chicken with the bones, everything, adds lots of garlic, adds vegetables, you know, take the bones after she's done cooking, you know, everything off the meat and throws it back in there, and then she has the broth. Bones and then puts in, you know, the vegetables and stuff, and it seems like her family heals from, you know, whatever, you know, cold, whatever, they seem to recover faster, you know, they're back on their feet and not feeling, you know, so sick for so long. And that's one thing. The brother that called in with the military information, I'd like to have some of that information. I don't know if you have a website, you can post it on either Blog Talk or on Straightway Truth Live video, or on our forum on straightway. There's so many places past your valley, sometimes I go cross-site, I don't know which way to go. Anyhow, he also has some information at FDA. I like to get that information because I like looking at that kind of information because I think it's important overall. I mean, most important is, you know, of course, what you teach us and everything, but this other stuff, worldly stuff, even though, you know, it's hard it is to swallow, but we're still in it, and, you know, when you're talking military or FDA, it's kind of nice to know what's the next thing they may be shooting at us. And last but not least, real quick, I knew that China had something going on with a factory for Boeing, and they just didn't have a link that could, you know, verify it, because people say, what? No, no, they're not it. Yes, they are. Real quick, is one sentence. Aircraft Manufacturing Boeing and Aviation Industries Corporation of China, also, if you want to shorten it, ABIC, on Monday unveiled, and this is from April 25th, 2011, a new factory as part of their composites joint venture, also if you want to read, just as JV in Tianjin, I guess that's someplace in China, as Chinese companies are set to become more involved in global aviation manufacturing. One last sentence. With an investment of $21 billion from Boeing, the new plant will boost the production capacity of the JV Boeing Tianjin Composites Corporation by 60%, and full production will begin there by 2013. So this came out 2011 in April, and so it's been in effect so far this year, and they're producing, making parts for planes like the 337, the 747-8667, 777, and 787, and blah, blah, blah. They also include the Hexcel, Goodrich, and Korean airspace industries. So I just want to share that with everyone, because Boeing is in China, even though some of their places say, you know, Seattle and stuff, but overall, and I think they had to sell the copy, or whatever you call it, of the parts to China, because it was part of China's deal. So I think China's making also parts from those blueprints and selling them for cheaper, so they actually are competing against our American so-called companies. So I just want to share that. Yeah. Pastel, thank you again so much for all your teachings, because like I said in my email to you, if I hadn't found you, if y'all hadn't guided me to you, I probably would have been trapped in Satan's world and not knowing what to do, because without knowing, like you said, from the man that's been anointed by God sharing the information, I would have probably just been... That's why I think a lot of us knew that in our heart something was wrong, and we had to search, and then God just, boom, right there. There you were, showing me how to make my alarm bag and kind of how to start it. So I'll let you go. Thank you very much. I love you, and I respect you. You're my pastor, and good night.
All right. Bless you, Sister Marjorie. Shabbat shalom. All right, anyway, I'm done. I'm tapped out for the night. I bless each and every last one of you, sweet, precious, and strong. Victorious, mighty, overcoming name, our soon coming King, Jesus the Christ. Shabbat shalom. We have a restful night. The King is coming. Shalom.
Look at him looking.